Okay, hi, Gian. So nice to finally meet you in person.
My pleasure.
So I want to start our interview with a special section. I was wondering whether you could join me in interpreting one song from the musical Don Juan.
My pleasure.
Changer pour que l'amour s'étend des forêts de Shanghai à l'Irlande pour qu'il n'y ait que l'amour quand il faudra se rendre.
So how does it feel to bring this yet another, you know, French musical staple to China?
It's very particular because that's not only another French musical to China, but mostly it's a new show for China. And the content of the story, it's always pretty actual and modern, you know, where hate can carry you, where love can carry you, but mostly the power of love, you know. Well, first of all, how to get in touch with the flamenco bass. To do that was simply breathtaking for all of us because we discovered inspiring skill that we could add to the show. And then obviously we learn how to fence with swords. It needs to be really realistic, but it needs to follow the music, you know.
Earlier this year, you have deeply impressed Chinese audiences with your rendition of Belle from Notre Dame de Paris, you know, together with Chinese artists at this year's Spring Festival Gala.
It was an incredible experience, honestly, and definitely a milestone of my career and my life. It was the first time, you know, that we could match and mix up together with, you know, with wonderful Chinese artists. And also because the song itself, it's such a legend, you know. And it was very, very interesting. And I think it was a, you know, thumbs up moment to see how incredibly good sounds also in Chinese language. So I'm really, really happy that, you know, the performance got kind of viral on stage. And I can't wait to have to experience other, maybe, you know, songs in the future with other wonderful artists in China.
Notre Dame de Paris was actually the reason you decided to become a musical performer.
Between 14 and 15 years old, and a friend of mine just showed me the DVD of the show, and I fell in love immediately. And definitely in Europe, Notre Dame was kind of a turning point for the business, you know, because it was a very modern style that didn't really exist, you know. So you had the British way and American way, you know, of shows, but Notre Dame is unique. There is a classic modern way of singing, you know. I mean, bear in mind, you really need strong voices to sing Notre Dame de Paris. It's a very, very demanding show to sing. And to see how passionate people in China are, make us simply want to come back again and again and again and again. So for me, China has become already, you know, a second home. I really hope that this kind of, you know, relationship that we started, you know, between me and the Chinese audience can, you know, can last forever, because for me it's simply a gift.
And performing musicals can be physically challenging. So I'm curious to know your fitness routine.
And the most difficult thing to understand about, you know, this business, it's that discipline needs to be the constant of a musical performer life. I always use the morning, you know, to meditate a bit and to work out at the gym. Your body is your engine, so you need to fill your body with quality food. But, you know, we are very lucky because Chinese food is really, really good and most of the time really, really healthy, so I love it. I stick a lot with mi fan, but base mi fan. And it's such an incredible culture, you know, and that's also the privilege to travel so much. The west side is different kitchen cuisine wise from the east side, so at the end, you know, you experience everything and you sum up.
And can you tell us more about, you know, anything you would like to tackle in the future?
I'd love to play Phantom one day, or Javert dans Les Mis. Yes, we were talking about the ingredients of the French musical composition, you know, musical composition. Every kind of, you know, emotion, situation has a particular musical vibe. I wish to myself that I can, you know, continue this journey in the musical panorama in China, and maybe, you know, also experience some TV. Why not some movie here in the, you know, in China. Let's see what the future brings up.